Historic Melaka. It's a World Heritage Site conferred by UNESCO, and its history spans over 600 years. Located on the west coast of the peninsula, Melaka's history began with the Malay Sultans. The epic tale of Hang Tuah is well known among locals. In 1511, the Portuguese arrived and they captured Melaka. They built the A Famosa and remained in Melaka for 130 years. The Dutch wrestled Melaka from the Portuguese in 1641. And remain in Melaka for the next 160 years. In 1824, Melaka was exchanged for Bencoolen and it became a British colony. It remained so until the independence of Malaysia. The history of Melaka is well known to the locals. But let's discover how Melaka has changed and developed over the years. In the heart of Melaka lies the Melaka River. The river serves as a lifeline to the city and a means to travel to the interior. The river also cuts the city in two, dividing it to its southern part around St. Paul's Hill and the Old Town in the north. Since ancient times, a bridge was used to connect the two parts of the town. Nowadays, there is a modern bridge over the river. The history surrounding St. Paul's Hill goes all the way back to the founding of Melaka. The hill served as a fortification ground since the Malay Sultanate period, and on it stood the Grand Palace of the Sultan. After the Portuguese captured Melaka, they built an enormous stone fortress around the hill. In the fight to capture Melaka from the Portuguese, much of the fort was destroyed. Thereafter, the Dutch rebuilt and strengthened the fortress of Melaka. In 1806, when Melaka was under British care, an order was given to destroy the fortress. All that remains today is the old gateway. But the gateway is Dutch, not Portuguese. Rebuilt in 1670, it was officially named after Balthazar Bot, the Dutch governor of Melaka. It was also known as the Land Port or Land Gate. There was another gateway that served as an entrance to the river and the town. A part of it can be seen on the left of this picture. This entrance was used since the Portuguese era. The Dutch repaired the damaged gates and used them for their fortress. The main part of the fort was the town square. It served as the main administrative center for the town and colony during Dutch times. The old Dutch Reformed Church was the center of religion for the Dutch people in Melaka. It later became an Anglican church during British times. Dutch Square is also known as Red Square because of the red buildings there. But in Dutch times, the buildings were white. The Stead House continued to serve as Melaka's administrative building until the 1980s. Today, it serves as a touristic icon for historic Melaka and a testament to its Dutch era. In the center of the fortress is St. Paul's Hill. And on the hill is the ruined church of St. Paul's. Built by the Portuguese, the Dutch made it a reformed church after they captured Melaka. It was the Bovenkerk. The old Dutch tombstones have been placed leaning on the church walls. Before 1924, it could be clearly seen that it was a graveyard. St. Francis Xavier is said to have been buried here for a short while, and Mass is said annually on his feast day. Across the river from the fortress leads to the old part of Melaka town. To protect the town and Melaka's center of economy, a fortification was built to defend it against possible threats from its enemies. It had wooden walls and a gate that led to Trunkera. Its landscape has changed little since the 1680s. The Dutch quarter in the town was known as Kampung Belanda. It was made up of the Jonkerstraat and Herenstraat. Jonkerstraat is now known as Jonker Street or Jalan Hang Jebat. The long and narrow buildings here are a product of the Dutch era. This is because taxes had to be paid based on the width of the frontage. Herenstraat is now known as Heren Street or Jalan Tun Tan Cheng Lok. It was on this narrow street where the highest Dutch officials in Melaka lived. Kampung Belanda has now become Melaka's Chinatown. There is a street in the old town called Harmony Street. Here, there is an Indian temple, a Malay mosque, and a Chinese temple all in one row. Nowhere else in Malaysia is there such a thing. The three houses of worship here are some of the oldest in Malaysia. With over 600 years of history, Melaka's mixed heritage of Asian and European influences is not only seen in its historical buildings, but also in its living heritage. In July 2008, Melaka was included in UNESCO's World Heritage List. Its core heritage zone, civic zone, and buffer zone in the historical part of the town became protected areas. Nevertheless, Melaka has gone through much development and changes over the centuries. Thank you. In only 40 years, Melaka has changed dramatically, as clearly seen from these aerial photographs. Even its coastline has changed. The old Melaka only remains in history. The quaint little town, once known as the Sleepy Hollow, has now grown in just a few short years to become a metropolitan city. Surrounded by progress, can this historic town resist being enveloped by the modern development surrounding it? It has to, or lose its heritage status. For now, only time will tell.